transfer that into good form yet. Ooh. This is one impressive youngster, Mohamed Musa. Keeps the batters guessing. Just hustles you, doesn't he?
Yeah, I think the reason why he hustles you is that he's not a very tall, fast bowler. He's skinny. A little action that comes through, and the ball just kisses the ground, speeds through to the wicketkeeper, and he gets a bit of shape, which is the key. You can't just be gun barrel straight when you're the size of Mohamed Musa. So, economy a little bit expensive, but the wicket's pretty good.
Played uppishly. Again, a double. Roy and Watson, pressure on these two internationals.
Yeah, a little leading edge almost. There's a little bit of swing out there for Musa, so he's got a little bit of work here. He's got a
down the ground and shipped before. Great start to the fourth over of the power play.
Jason Roy completed the last over with a single down the ground. Similar shot here, he gets a full toss. Musa searching for the Yorker. He doesn't miss by much, but Jason Roy, the kind of form that he's in this evening, he does not miss out. Bottom hand, but down the ground.
Oh wow! No need to move when Roy is in the mood.
Yeah, I think those sixes for the most sixes in an innings is going to be tested. Jason Roy continues with this. This is incredible. He stands, Tesco doesn't even watch it. 84 meters, that is gone.
All you have to do in that time is the dust track dance move, right? You don't even need to do anything. No commentary even required. Boy. Shane Watson has gone for 9 of 8, it's 41 for 1.
Player. I mentioned Sad. 42 matches, strike rate of just over 120, best of 99. .41 still in over to go in the power play. Oh, that hurts. That does hurt Michael Slater. Ouch!
It's one of those, everyone else laughs, by you. Why is that, Dominic?
Well, it just hits on the inside of the knee.
I thought it was somewhere else, but it might be that inside of the knee. Or just below that thigh guard on the back leg. The inner thigh, he's gone. Big shot. Skew, and it's just, it looks like he's wearing a thigh guard on that back leg, and it's just hit below that. So it's a dead leg, bit of a corky. Dominic?
Corky. That's an Australian word, a corky.
Haven't you had a corky, corky?
I've had a corky, let me tell you. I know exactly what you'd be saying to me if I'd have gone down like that.
Well, the first thing is that you wouldn't have come down. Spirit of cricket, Dominic.
You'd have said toughen up. It is that wicked. Shane Watson looked despondent, Michael Slater.
Well, he's always the most unlucky batsman when he gets out, but he needed to hit that for six. It was there, a bit more of an up and under. He drilled it. It was out of the middle. It was just a simple flick. And he hits with such power, he needed a little bit more elevation. And it's a very handy wicket. They needed to break that partnership.
Let's get down to Erin.
Yes, of course, as part of the HBL PSL, we are celebrating Hamari Heroes, powered by Inverex, the unsung heroes of Pakistan. And Narina Shams, you are our Hamari Hero for today. You are such a talented woman. You were the youngest ever to get a silver medal at the Junior Olympics in cycling, but you're now a professional squash player.
Thank you so much for actually calling me here. I mean, this is something very different. And I'm so, so happy to be here. I mean, the crowd is so amazing. Thank you so much for such an amazing introduction. You're amazing yourself.
Oh, you're an incredible sportsman, and you know, we're very pleased to have you here with us today, but you also have a very important role as the youngest advisor to the sports minister of KP as well, I believe.
Yeah, I mean, I was shocked when I got that post, but I guess with this amazing post or something, I believe believe that it's a very big responsibility for producing such facilities that were not there for me when I was playing, and I just want to make sure that I just make most out of this post while I'm sitting. And I'm so happy that I'm the only player sitting with, on the table with them, and I'm so happy and glad that I'm the youngest as well.
So such important work that you're doing. Now, I believe you have a special connection with a certain Nazim Shah as well. Talk us through that.
Okay, so there's no such special connection. We're just like from the same area. We happen to be from the same village as well. And I mean, I would say that we had almost the same stories of coming here. Yeah.
And do you like cricket? Have you played cricket? Is that one of the many sports that you've played?
Yeah. There was a phase where I was playing not only with girls, but with boys as well in Peshawar. And I was in All Boys Academy. So, yeah, there was a craze at that time as well before joining the squad.
Well, congratulations. We're so thrilled to have us here with you today. Please sign the Inverex bat. I have to let her go because she's got some very important squash games coming up in the next couple of days. But thank you so much. You've been an absolutely incredible inspiration. And we're proud to have you as our Hamari hero for today's game.
Yeah, the multi-talented Noreena Shams. We are, what, 3 balls away from the end of the power play. Michael Slater, I'm going to put you under pressure. Where's this game at the moment?
Quetta to lose. They've only lost the 1 wicket. I think they've got themselves in a really good position. Those wickets in the first six are crucial in a run chase. They've only lost the one. So I think they're looking good. The fact that Roy's still out there as well. He's 34 from 25. He's a powerhouse. He can play and miss occasionally. It's a perfect deck for him. The fact that it's quick. It's coming through in the true style. He just tries to overhit this one. But when you play the way he does, you need a little bit of luck as well. But it's just the sort of pitch where he can crash through a line. The mistake he makes sometimes, he'll hit at a catchable height. If he picks a fielder out, like Watson did, then he might be walking back. But it's this start. Once he gets to 34, he's hard to stop.
Also, he tries to overhit it sometimes. He's a powerful man. His back comes from what gully, it comes down across towards mid on, hence why he hits it really well when he gets himself in a position, gives himself a bit of room, Michael Slater, and that was very Michael Slater-esque.
He's quality, isn't he? He is a quality player, and he's making the most of quality conditions here at Royal Pitney. All credit to the ground staff because they've churned out a batting friendly pitch, so the bowlers are probably not too happy about it. But he gives himself room to open up the offside. There's no one back there. And now a change in field. Third man is coming up. That's the nature of his play. He's got the captain thinking all the time, what do I do? How do we stop these fours?
Well, Musa has to go in now. Now what Jason Roy's got to do, he's got to give himself a little bit of room. There he goes, better length. He'll get a single. And that is the end of the power play. 50 up for Quetta, 50 for one.